Welcome to Reality Creative Video. I'm Hermes, and today we're going to cover some things that I've been working on and some things that may be working on in the future. It's just going to be a general show on various things. Now, first, last week we talked about the lenses in the microscope that came, the new Andonstar microscope. And we were unable to identify the power of those lenses, because the way the manufacturer sells it, they don't tell you the power of the lenses. So I wasn't completely happy with the lenses, so I ordered new lenses. I ordered a 10x. This is now outfitted with all the new lenses. I ordered a 4x lens, a 10x lens, 20x lens, and a 40x lens. So I got all of these things filled now. So I've covered all the lenses, and I figured out that the two lenses that it came with, well, three if you want to count the one that I talked about, that you got to remove all this and then put the single lens back in here. So that single lens that comes back in here is a 4x, which to all my purposes, or even your purposes, is kind of not useful at all, because you have to remove this whole thing and change it to put that 4x in there. Then it comes with these two other lenses, and this one here, the red one here, that's rated at 7-8 millimeters. This one winds up being a 10x lens, and this one with the blue line winds up being which is a 3-4 millimeter distance lens, winds up to be a 20x lens. So, and these are not achromatic lenses. I don't know what kind of lenses they are, but they do not correct for refraction or color. They're just lenses. So the new lenses I got correct for reflection and aberration, and what they may give you a much sharper image and less reflected surfaces, which for our intensive purposes, we need the less reflected surfaces as possible, because we're shooting pictures of colloidals using a laser beam. So I have to say there's a substantial improvement in using the achromatic lenses over the stock lenses that came with the microscope. This right here is a gold, colloidal gold. I was cooking colloidal gold yesterday. This is ruby red colloidal gold, and so I shot some pictures of the latest batch of colloidal gold, and I'll show you microscope pictures of the colloidal gold, a regular 4x and a 10x picture of the colloidal gold. How kind of impressive. The 4x is definitely impressive, and the 10x you can start to see the actual size of the colloidal gold particles, which you can't really see in the 4x. So that's kind of new. We're going to have to explore that 10x lens, and even the 20x lens is going to give me a little bit more exploration into the size of some of these smaller colloidals. So I'm sure I'll have plenty to say about that in the future, right? So that's it. The lenses, that's basically going to take up some new time this week. So what else? Okay, this is my top that goes on my beakers. And then the rods go in here. This new top, I think I've talked about it, has got these things on here. And they help keep the whatever you're cooking perfectly straight. Now, the problem I have with this top is it works great until I put it in a beaker full of gold, when I'm cooking gold. When I cook gold, we're talking 93 degrees C, almost boiling of heat. And the previous material that I made the tops out of just doesn't stand up. I might get a couple gold uses out of it, and then it just breaks apart into a million pieces. So this material that it's took me several weeks to figure out how to print on this material is 40 degrees C higher melting temperature. And while I haven't fully extensively tested this yet, I'm hoping that this top will actually survive more than 4 or 5 gold-making processes. Maybe survive forever, you know, being with the extra 40 degrees C melting point on this. I'm hoping will give me the stability I need so I don't have to keep printing new tops. As I said before, it takes about 6 hours to print one of these tops. So, you know, I keep a spare when or if these things breaks apart, but it'd be nice to not have to print them on a regular basis. Also makes it hard for me to make these available to others when they're not yet perfected. So that was this week's project too that I was working on. I have, I'm going to be cooking zinc today. I didn't get it started yet. And I'm going to cook it differently, and I'll let you know how I make out with that. I'm going to cook it with citric acid instead of sodium citrate as an accelerant. Now, you can cook zinc with no accelerant whatsoever. It takes about 5 hours to cook. I 5 hours is a long time when you have a whole lot of colloidals to cook. So, normally I use sodium citrate to cook zinc, but me and my chemist were talking about the sodium contained in the sodium citrate and how it could spawn secondary iconic processes with zinc and other various metals. So I'm going to experiment this today on using citric acid to increase the conductivity of the solution. And I don't think there's going to be any kind of issues with it, but that's just something I'm going to be working on today. And I will probably have a report on how that works out in a future show. Upcoming, I have not forgot about our magnesium video. I'm really hoping I can get to making magnesium from start to finish this week. Again, magnesium is another long cooking colloidal. And the problem I have with magnesium is the strips are so thin that anything I try to use as an accelerant makes them break up. And if I just stick the magnesium strips in there, now we're looking at another 5 or 6 hour process in order to cook magnesium. So I'm going to also try citric acid with magnesium and see what happens. I have a feature show going to cover the differences between iconic solutions and colloidal solutions. What's the difference? So I got a show coming up on that because I don't think everybody really understands the difference between them. The reason that's attached to the magnesium thing that I was just talking about is that when you mix citric acid with magnesium, it starts to dissolve the magnesium. And then you get what we consider an iconic solution in there. Now, I'm hoping the small amount of citric acid I'm going to use is not going to dump a whole lot of iconic in there. And we'll have mostly colloidals when I do that test. So we'll see. And that's the final thing with the magnesium that I'm waiting to figure out. I want to tell you guys how to make magnesium, but I need to figure out the best way to do that. So that's my final test on it. And then I'm going to do the actual start to finish magnesium video. Look forward to a few more shows this week on various topics. I'm trying to spread the topics out, so because I know some of you are only interested in the alchemy and the colloidals, and some of you are interested in the herbal stuff, and other people are interested in the spiritual stuff. So I'm trying to have shows to cater to all of my visitors to the website and to YouTube. So we'll see how it goes. I'm Hermes. This is Reality Creative Video, and I will talk to you again soon.